So far, the trend is still intact. In fact, yesterday's move that we saw was a short covering move for the 2 days that we saw in profit booking. So far, it's good. We have closer to the high that we saw earlier. So it's not bad, but we could see some kind of satisfaction. But today, it looks to me that it's more of a trending day. Not very comfortable with Bank Nifty though, because we saw a new high on Bank Nifty futures, not in cash. So perhaps in the upper region they're selling, but so far even the trend is still intact up. But looks like we would have a trend day in Nifty. Bank Nifty, I'm not very sure. I have four stocks here. I'll go for all buy and take a risk on the upside. Coal India looks like a buy, so the move is starting out here. Target on the upside is 220, stop below 199. I like Grasim as well. Looks like it can climb to around 765 zones. Stop below 730. M&M Financial is looking good to me. Possibly target on the upside is 370. Stop below 344. And there's a good momentum buildup in Vedanta. I think it's heading up to levels closer to 175 zones. Stop below 160 should be okay.
I think a couple of things which you highlighted. One, it kind of confirms that the uptrend is not over. So what has happened is that we became quite overbought with the 2 days of rally. Then had a breather, a pullback kind of sort, and there was buying at lower level. So one, just 11, 4, 16, 420, I think becomes a very important pivot on the downside. And I think on the upside, we will still see supply or profit booking happening as we get closer to 11, 650 levels. So I think it might be a few days of breather as we kind of consolidate the gains. Then we might be in range bound between 11, 400, 420, maybe 450 on the downside to about 11, 600, 650 on the upside. And I think that kind of movement is expected to continue. Eventually, I would expect an upside breakout. So the idea right now should be to trade with stock-specific bias or buy on declines when it comes to indices. I think only one on the sell side, and I have three buys. I have a buy on Ashok Leyland. I think came down to gap levels yesterday to good support and is giving a reversal. So any mild declines if the SGX suggests in the morning should be used to buy into this one. It's around 72.5, 72.75 is where I would suggest buying. Keep a stop below 70, look for targets of 77. Chola Finance is showing signs of continuation on the upside. Buy with a stop at 303, look for 326 as the target. And Divi's has had a very good candlestick pattern, so that's a buy with a stop below 1650. Look for targets close to about 1730 there. And one sell call, that's on Rel Infra. Sell with a stop at 3625 for targets of 32.
Well, my prognosis is quite similar. I would say that after that huge rally, we have had 4 days of consolidation. And yesterday's kind of price movement suggests that probably we are actually forming a bullish tight flag. What does it imply? It implies that there could be something similar in store. May not be so dramatic, but something quite bullish that is in store. And market seems to be in anticipation of that and consolidating. So unless you see the index falling below 11,500 again, I think we would see upward move, and 11,655 to about 11,695 is supply window. If this resistance zone is crossed, then there is a possibility that we would be headed for 11,800 kind of levels. So I'm quite positive on the market, and I feel that even Bank Nifty, which Prakash rightly said that there is a slight bit of problem, but then Bank Nifty might join in, and the likes of HDFC Bank and ICICI banks, once they support the thing, then Bank Nifty might also join in. So I continue to remain bullish. Again, all buys. I mean, I would say first to start with, Bajaj Finance, again a similar kind of tight flag formation on the upside. So there is a possibility that Bajaj Finance can actually move up from here. I'm looking at levels of 4070 to about 4087 for the day, but the trend might continue and put a stop loss below 3968. And second buy call is on Tata Steel. I think metals would do well today, and Tata Steel, I would put a stop loss below 373. And Tata Steel's chart formation suggests that there is a lot of upside movement still left to be done. Target is 387. And finally, HPCL. Of the two, BPCL and HPCL, I like HPCL because its chart pattern is much safer and not like vertical move in BPCL. I would put a stop loss below 296. 317 and 321 are the two targets for HPCL. All three buys.